First Temple period, Jerusalem faced constant threats. Despite this, the city grew in status and religious significance. So how did the historical events of biblical times strengthen Jerusalem's status as a holy city? Let's start at the beginning. 3,000 years ago, King David sought to unify the tribes of Israel. He made Jerusalem the capital of his kingdom, the seat of government, and the religious center of the nation. His son, King Solomon, built the temple in the city, further enhancing its religious importance. Yet the tribes did not remain united for long, and the monarchy split into two, the Kingdom of Israel and the Kingdom of Judah. The kingdoms were governed separately until the mighty Assyrian Empire, seeking to control the region as empires do, arrived and vanquished them. When the Kingdom of Israel rebelled and refused to pay taxes, the Assyrians punished it mercilessly. They destroyed its capital and exiled much of its population. Judah now faced the campaign alone. Despite the Kingdom of Israel's devastation, King Hezekiah of Judah, who remained in Jerusalem, chose to oppose the Assyrian Empire. Anticipating the arrival of the Assyrian army, led by King Sennacherib, Hezekiah walled and fortified the city's western hill. He dug the Siloam Tunnel to channel water to the city from the Gihon Spring, denying the Assyrians water and enabling Jerusalem to withstand a siege. However, Hezekiah dreaded the might of the Assyrians, whose campaign in Judah had devastated much of the kingdom. And despite the preparations for a siege, he decided to surrender. However, surrender was no longer an option for Sennacherib, and it seemed that armed conflict was inevitable. As the Assyrians stood poised to attack Jerusalem's walls, inside the city, the prophet Isaiah foretold that the city would not be destroyed, despite Hezekiah's fears and the unequal balance of power. Hezekiah and all those in Jerusalem could only hope and pray. The Assyrians claimed that Jerusalem was taken and surrendered. However, the Bible relates a different story. As night fell, the angel of the Lord struck down the Assyrian army. When morning dawned, the miracle was revealed. Tens of thousands of soldiers lay dead in the Assyrian camp. Jerusalem was saved. The account of the miracle reinforced the city's sacred status. Over a century later, it was the Babylonians' turn. In true imperial tradition, they also instigated military campaigns and sought to capture the kingdom of Judah.
Despite many hardships, those
also returned to Zion, rebuilt the second temple, which was more modest than the first. The scribe Ezra reintroduced the Torah and its laws. Nehemiah, appointed governor of Judah by the Persians, restored Jerusalem's walls, fortifying the city and reaffirming the temple's status. Jerusalem rose from its ashes, despite